Hi, I'm Luca Bartolomei from Vision for Robotics Lab at ETH Zurich. In this video, we are going to talk about our work, Semantic-aware Active Perception for UAVs using deep reinforcement learning. Nowadays, robots such as unmanned aerial vehicles are more and more used in a variety of applications, such as drone delivery. Tons of research has been carried out in order to increase the capacity of these platforms to navigate autonomously. However, safety still remains a big challenge, as the integrity of both the platform and the surroundings has to be maintained. Plus, accurate and robust pose estimation are another vital component in order to succeed in a mission. The most used sensors, such as GPS, can however fail in a number of situations, for example in presence of bad weather or tall buildings. Imagine a drone navigating in a city. In this case, a direct line of sight between the sensor and the satellite is not possible, and a signal is reflected on the buildings. This will cause large error in position estimates and motivates the need for more robust and reliable solutions. Vision-based navigation is a valid alternative. The idea is to go from camera images to pose estimates without the need of an external sensor, such as GPS. On the other hand, vision-based estimators greatly rely on the appearance of the scene. Dynamic scenes or reflective surfaces can cause large errors in the position estimates and failures in the estimation process. To alleviate such problems, research has been carried out in the field of active perception. In active perception, the objective is to reach a given destination while minimizing the error in pose estimates. In particular, semantics can be a valuable source of information to identify reliable areas for localizations, such as buildings and terrain, and distinguish them from unreliable areas such as woods or busy roads. Semantics can then guide the robot to reach its destination safely and accurately. In the literature, the current state of the art uses a binary approach with respect to semantic classes, meaning it differentiates them depending on their usefulness for vision-based state estimation. In this work, we extend this idea, and we employ the full semantic information. The main concept is that the different semantic classes can carry different levels of perceptual importance, and using a binary classifier would be an oversimplification of reality. In order to deal with this richer semantic information, we use a deep reinforcement learning approach. In the following, we illustrate the pipeline in more details. As a first step, the RGB image captured by the camera goes through a semantic classification step. The semantic mask is then used as input to the reinforcement learning agent. We directly feed the semantic mask instead of the RGB image because, as demonstrated by Chen et al., this mid-level representation can allow for faster training. If we directly fed the raw image, policy generalization would be harder to achieve, as the same semantic class may have different visual appearances. In order to reduce the complexity of the problem, here, we assume high-quality segmentation masks as input to the policy. The output of the policy is then a set of weights that can get a value in the continuous range between 0 and 1. These weights represent the perceptual informativeness per semantic class. This is the key component that differentiates us from the state of the art, as here the policy is tasked to find the right balance between the different classes instead of classifying them in a binary fashion. In order to map the semantic mask to the set of weights, we model the RL agent as an actor-critic policy, composed by a set of convolutional layers followed by an STM. This memory module is employed to identify some spatial relationships between the different classes, such as roads and cars, that would otherwise be hard to identify. Then, the actor outputs the action, which correspond to the weights in our case, and the critic outputs the Q value. The policy is then optimized in an episode-based fashion by using the PPO algorithm. The output of the policy, together with the destination pose, is then fed to the path planning framework by Bartolomei et al., modified in order to accommodate for the policy action space. Then, the depth images, together with the RGB images, are fed to the estimation module. The visual odometry estimator communicates the poses and the semantically labeled 3D landmarks to the path planner, while the depth image is used by the mapper to generate a 3D occupancy map of the environment that is used for obstacle avoidance. Finally, the path planning module outputs the trajectory that is fed to the controller of the robot. As the main core of this work is on the reinforcement learning component, we now describe how such a policy is trained. During policy training, the objective is to maximize the total reward in an episode-based fashion. This reward is composed of different parts. The first one is the reward associated to the survival of the visual odometry estimator. The idea is to incentivize actions that avoid losing track of landmarks or cause failure in the post-estimation process. Then, in the second component, the objective is to minimize the localization error, that is the distance between the current estimate and the ground truth position. Finally, we reward the policy if it flies the robot closer to the final destination. At the beginning of each episode, we generate a random 3D scene using the game engine Unity, and we sample an initial pose and a destination environment randomly. The episode is then composed of many training steps, where Unity provides the policy with the semantic mask, which is mapped to a set of perceptual informativeness values. These values are fed to the path planning module that generates trajectories and informs Unity how the robot has moved. An episode is composed of many training loops and ends when either the state estimator loses track or the final destination is reached. In this video, we show a few training episodes in randomly generated scenes in Unity. It is possible to see the visual tracks by the vision-based estimator and the top view of the randomly generated scene. The input to the policy is the semantic mask, while the output is a set of weights. Notice that here we limit the policy to a set of 6 classes, but our design does not restrict the number of possible classes in use. During each episode, the rewards are collected and then the policy is optimized using the PPO algorithm. When the state estimator loses track, the episode ends. But as the policy gathers more experience, it is able to safely navigate the robot to the destination more frequently, getting higher rewards in return. In this plot, we show the performance of the policy over the training episodes. Along the horizontal axis, we report the number of episodes, while on the left axis, we report the total reward, where higher values means better performance. On the right side, instead, the positional root mean square error is indicated. In this case, the lower the value, the better the performance. In the plot, we can identify two main phases. In the first one, we see that the policy quickly learns which semantic classes are the best one for state estimation, with rapid improvements in both the total reward and in RMSC. In the second part, the total reward remains constant, while there are bigger fluctuations in the state estimation error. In this phase, the policy is able to fly the robot more frequently to the destination. As a consequence, the reward does not drop, despite an increase in the RMSC in the final episodes. The learned policy is then tested directly without additional fine-tuning in a set of models not experienced at training time. There are two sets of models. Three of them are created using the game engine Unity, while three other models are generated using photogrammetry from real-life places. The video showed the experiment and the test runs in the second set of models, and here we show the resemblance between the real-life place and the 3D reconstruction. We compare our approach against three other planners. The planner by Zhang and Scaramuzza uses the landmark concentration as main metric to decide whether a region is reliable for state estimation. Instead, the approach by Bartolomei et al. Uses semantic information but associates a fixed binary importance to each semantic class in the scene. The reactive planner is also based on this planner, but it does not consider perception at all and tries to find the shortest path to the destination. Finally, we show the path flown by the robot using our learned policy that employs the full semantic information to take a decision. The planner by Zhang and Scaramuzza, as it does not consider semantic information at all, flies the robots in large detours that bring to lower success rate and higher state estimation error. In the following experiments, we instead show the importance of semantic information. Thanks to the usage of semantics at planning time, Our planner and the planner by Bartolomei et al. Are able to reach higher success rates. This demonstrates that semantics can be a valuable source of information to consider in order to generate meaningful trajectories towards a destination. However, our planner consistently reaches the highest success rates thanks to its ability of changing the weighting scheme online and dynamically adapting to the scene. Finally, the reactive planner tries to find the shortest path to the destination without considering its perception. As a consequence, its performance in terms of success rate and estimation error are lower compared to our approach. As seen from the video, our policy can generate actions online and can generalize on scene scenarios without the need of additional fine-tuning. Here we report the numerical results of the test runs over 20 experiments per each model. In the top part of the table, we show the summary of the results in the scene created with Unity, while in bottom part, the result in the reconstructions of real-life places. In both cases, our planner beats our competitors in success rate and robustness. It also presents a decrease in localization error, both in RMSE, that indicates the error between the estimated position and the ground truth, and in the miss distance, that is the distance between the end position of the robot and the actual real destination. All of this happens at expense of a slightly higher travel distance, but this is expected, as our planner will deviate the trajectory in order to track the best landmarks in view and improve the state estimation performance. To conclude, in this work we present a semantic-aware active perception planner for UAVs that uses deep reinforcement learning. We demonstrate that the proposed policy architecture can avoid perceptually degraded regions thanks to the capacity of the planner to adapt dynamically to the scene in view. In the extensive evaluation carried out in a set of photorealistic models and reconstructions of real-life places, we demonstrate that our approach is generalizable to unseen environment at training time without the need of additional fine-tuning. It also beats the current state-of-the-art in active perception, both in success rate and post-estimation error. As future work, our goal is to replace the high-quality segmentation masks with the output of actual semantic segmentation neural networks, and to adapt the policy architecture to deal with the uncertainty in the semantic labels.